Good morning, good morning, good morning. Glory be to God this morning, this beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning. I say that because the word says that this is the day the Lord has made, and we should rejoice and be glad in it. We know it's raining outside, but we give God the glory. We know that there's a storm out in the Gulf, but we still yet give God the glory. We thank God for this opportunity to just give him the praise and give him the honor and give him all the glory. Why? Because he's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised at all times and all places. He always deserves the praise, the honor, and the glory. Why? Because he's God. He's almighty. He's everlasting. He's beginning and end. He's Alpha and Omega. We just thank God always. We give him the praise and honor and the glory. And then we say, he said, well, why are you always? I said, because of him that I live, move, and have my very existence. It's all because of him. It ain't because the alarm clock went off this morning, which I don't even use an alarm clock. He's my alarm clock. He woke me up this morning. He started me off today. And guess what? He did the same thing to you this morning. So we just give him praise. We give him honor. And we give him glory. That's our Lord, our Father. Yes, sir. We just thank him this morning. I greet each and every one of you, born again believers, in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. I greet you, and I just extend my love to you, just to let you know that I love you from right where I'm at, and I thank God for each and every one of you guys that are laboring with us in the gospel. I thank God for each and every one of you that's been chiming in every Sunday. And getting the word from on high. We thank you for just laboring in the gospel, getting this gospel message out, doing the will of God, telling everybody about the Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We just bless God for each and every member of this body of Christ, which we know we're just one particular group, but we got with one body with many members all around the world. We got believers all around the world supposedly be doing and working for the same purpose to reach the lost for Christ. To reach the lost for Christ. That's the sole purpose of the gospel, is to reach the lost for Christ. Christ came to save sinners. Yeah, Paul said, who I was chiefest of. So we got to keep in mind that the gospel message is to reach sinners. Yeah, because if you were already saved, then you don't need a savior. Yeah, if you already all that, then you didn't need a savior. You just good on your own. But the Bible said that we're saved by grace through faith in what Christ did. Yes, sir. Not by works that any man shall boast, and not of yourselves. So we got to keep that in mind. That we thank God for His Son Jesus this morning. We thank Him for His love and His mercy. And we just thank each and every believer for standing in the faith, standing in the faith. I pray that something today that will be said through the power of the Holy Spirit will help us in our day-to-day walk as the body of believers. I pray that if there's be a non-believer chiming in, that they will come in and receive Christ as Savior, repent, turn to Christ, and allow Him to be Lord of their life. I pray that even happened today. But whatever it is, it's going to be the will of God. And we just bless God for this beautiful Sunday morning. We're able to come together and share a word. I got to say this because I don't know. Don't know Born Again Believers Ministry. Don't really know when we're going to be able to go back into the building. But we always recognize that God is still using this ministry to get His will done. And even though we're not going into the four walls right now, the ministry is still moving forth in the gospel. We've had, since we've been out, we've had 5 new converts, 5 people to come and give their lives to Christ as Savior. We bless God for that. We know that we water and we plant and God gives the increase. Even though we haven't been going into the building, we got more members of the body of Christ. I don't get all wrapped up about numbers that's in this particular ministry. I get wrapped up about if one be saved, the angels in heaven rejoice. I want to see people saved. And if they can go to a Jesus Bible teaching church that's teaching true doctrine, then I'm blessed just to know that that person has been saved and they're going to be sitting up under the word of God, that they're going to get the real truth. They're going to get the truth. Brings us to the day that don't be deceived. Believers, don't be deceived. Believers, don't be deceived. Oftentimes, we have so many wolves out here that are really wanting to scatter the sheep. So what we're trying to do is we want us as the body of believers, those that are that I am pastoring, not only them, but those that are coming in and hearing the word, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. There's one gospel, and that's the gospel of Jesus Christ. That's one gospel. That's having faith in Christ and what he did up on Calvary. One gospel. Paul said in Galatians that if we come with any other kind of gospel, it is a curse. Let it be a curse. That's one gospel. And I don't have a problem with what somebody else want to believe, but body of believers, we need to stick with the gospel of Jesus Christ. I don't have a problem with what somebody else want to believe, but I believe that Christ died for my sin. I believe that Christ was buried for my sin. I believe that he was resurrected and I was justified by him being resurrected, that he died and took my sins away, and by his blood, I've been justified. And as the body of believers, there's only one way. And Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And I just want to come by to tell you that there will be deceivers. There will be those telling you there's another way. There will be those coming to tell you, well, if you're not doing this, then you're not doing that. No, there's one way, and he is the way. Jesus is the way. That ought to make you excited, because you ought to know that within yourself, there's nothing you could have done to save yourself. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I want to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. God has called me to be a preacher of the gospel. He says, son, preach my son. Son, preach Jesus crucified. I preach Jesus crucified. Why? Because the power of the gospel, it's the power of the gospel unto salvation. The only way you can be saved is believing upon the name of the Lord Jesus. Now, if you don't want to be saved, then you can believe anything else you want to believe. But the Bible said to him that don't believe it, you're already condemned. So believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Father, we thank you this morning for this opportunity, Lord, to stand before your people, Lord God, and preach the truth. Preach the truth. Preach the truth in love. And give your believers and those that will come upon you and believe, give them the word of God. Father, we ask that you use us in a mighty way. Use us, oh God, that everything that we do will come up as a sweet smelling savor to your nostrils, oh God. Father, we thank you. We bless you for this opportunity, oh God, to guide and lead your people through your word. Father, we thank you. We bless you. It is in Jesus' name that we pray. And I say amen. Amen. We have a couple of scriptures that we're going to go to today. You know how I do. I preach the word. I preach the word of God. I can't add to it and I can't take away from it. The scripture is coming out of the book. It's coming out of the book. I'm going to read to you out of the book. Allow Holy Spirit to open your hearts this morning and open your minds, that you too can be strengthened as believers. That way you won't be deceived with all kinds of doctrine and people come in and can tell you anything. Jesus said that the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. Jesus said that if anybody comes any other way to God, they are a thief and a robber. See, we got to understand that there's only one way. There's one way, and it's Jesus. I don't get into all that, well, Jesus this and Jesus that. I'm just telling you the only way for a believer is to believe upon the name of Jesus Christ. Now, if you don't want to believe upon that name, then don't call yourself a believer. If you don't believe that Christ has died for your sin, well, don't call yourself a believer. But believers, don't be deceived. Don't allow people to get into your ear and tell you that that's some other way to get saved other than Jesus Christ. I'm preaching that you be saved. salvation. And Jesus is the only way that you can obtain salvation. Hallelujah. I can't tell you about getting rich, because you just might get rich and die the next day and go to hell. I can't tell you about all these things that are going to happen in your life, because the Bible said that we will have trials. We will have tribulation. We will go through some difficulties as believers. That's what the Bible said. Yeah. But you got to understand that in Christ, we have peace that surpasses all understanding. You might have to sit in a wheelchair the rest of your life. I don't know. But I promise you, if you got Jesus, you got salvation. That's the true gospel. I just got to preach the gospel. I don't know where your future may take you, but I know if you believe upon the Lord Jesus Christ, you have salvation, everlasting life. It said, God so loved the world that whoever, come on now, that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth upon him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Believers, do not be deceived. There's no other way. There's no other way. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Paul, talking to Timothy in 2 Timothy. Something I just want to show us. Paul talking to Timothy in 2 Timothy. This young preacher who he had sent out to do missions, who had sent out to pastor his churches. And Paul was telling Timothy in this particular passage of scripture, I'm just going to grab something out of it, but I want you to go back, and I want you to go back in this and go starting at that chapter 3, 2 Timothy chapter 3. But I wanted to pull this out, and then I'm going to go somewhere else, but I wanted to pull this out for you right quick. 2 Timothy, good morning, believers. Good morning, everybody that's chiming in. I just say good morning, and God bless you and keep you. It's my prayer. And I want you to get more knowledge of the word so you won't be deceived. And you probably say, well, Pastor, why do you always continuously remind us about Christ and what he did upon Calvary? Because the disciples or the apostles, Paul, he had to continue to go back to the churches and remind them, because they always had false prophets coming up. You always had people coming up with all these other different ways and all these other different doctrines that was leading them away from Christ. So Paul had to continuously keep them in mind, continuously keep them stirred up. Well, do you think it has changed today? No, it has not. So a pastor must continue to feed his sheep that which they should already know, that they can continue to stay within the sheepfold. Hallelujah. Oftentimes we'll drift away because we want to hear something. The Bible said if you get an itching ear, you want to hear something that make your ear feel good. But I come to preach the gospel that's going to save your soul. Hallelujah. I don't care about your ear feeling good. I care about your soul being saved. And I care about that you having security and knowing that your soul has been saved if you became a believer under the pretense of it's only because of what Christ did up on Calvary. No other way, not by works, that any man should boast. When you say, well, I did all this for the church, and I gave $1,000 a week for so long, I know I'm saying, well, you might well cancel that salvation out because you can't pay for it. It's free. It was a free gift. But I go to church every Sunday, I know I'm saying, if that's why you think you're saved, then boom, cancel that one. Because it don't work like that. It's by grace, through faith in what Christ did up on Calvary. That's the only way that man is saved. He came to save sinners. And if you say you're righteous without it, then you still a sinner. We got to get it right. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Here it is, guys. Here it is. 2 Timothy, 3rd chapter. Paul told Timothy, but evil men and seducers shall wax worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. Yeah, he said, even in the last days, that deceivers, yeah, they will wax worse. That means they're going to get worse and worse in these last days. The last days, after Christ went up, from now on through till he come back. You in the last days, till he come back. And he said that they will be deceiving more, and guess what they will be? They will also be in deceived. The leaders will also be deceived. as well as the people that they're leading being deceived. Why? Because they want to hear something that make them feel good on the inside. They want to hear something that make them think that they all this and they all that. But the Bible said that we all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. He said the righteousness of man are as of filthy rags. Well, how can the Bible say one thing and then the deceiver can stand and tell a man something else different about themselves? Christ came to save sinners. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Here it is. He said, but continue thou in the things which thou hast learned and hast been assured of, knowing of whom that thou hast learned them. Yeah. And that from a child. Now you can take that from a child to when you first got born again, believers. You might have been walking in error until you heard the true gospel. And so you are a child. You're a baby in Christ. Because this walk, when you're real young, you really don't understand much anyway. But he said that from a child thou hast known the Holy Scriptures, which are able to make thee wise unto salvation through, pay attention, through faith which is in Christ Jesus. And I'm going to stop right there. Through faith that is in Christ Jesus. Paul said, but evil men. I thought everybody was good. Now, Paul said that evil men. I can't understand why the world or why people can't understand that men are evil. Men are evil. Physically evil, mentally evil, verbally evil. Men's hearts are evil. And they speak evil. And they deceive people evilly. Why? To have control over them. To lead them in a false way. Jesus said that wolf will scatter the sheep. He'll scatter the sheep. Why? Because he's a hireling. Because they pay him a check every week. He don't care about the sheep. Long as he get his check, then that's all he caring about. Paul said, be careful about these leaders like this. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. He said, but evil men and seducers, seducing spirits, guys, to get you to believe what they believe so they can get right up in that pocketbook. Yeah, Seducing, that is an essential wax coat, worse and worse, deceiving and being deceived. They be so deceived that they'll follow other folks that are deceiving them and they want to come deceive you. Be not deceived. Know that you have to be wise unto salvation through faith which is in Christ Jesus. And then he goes on to say, all scripture is given by inspiration of God and are profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for corrections, for instructions in righteousness. Everything that's in the scripture are there. It's there that the real doctrine, the true word is for reproof, is for corrections, is for instruction in righteousness. How did we get right? We accepted Christ as our Lord and Savior. And the righteousness is in Christ. It's all in Christ. You cannot be righteous apart from having Christ. Man cannot be righteous apart from having Christ. That's the gospel. Any other righteousness is as a filthy rag unto God. He don't care about that. If you don't believe upon his son, Jesus Christ, according to the book, it's no good. Okay? Well, why you say that, Pastor? Well, here we go. Go to John 1. Go to John 1. I got to give you this so you won't be tossed around with foolish wives' tales and fake doctrine. The believers have got to be strong in the word that in order for us to reach the lost, we're going to have to know what we're talking about. We can't be deceived. We can't be deceived. And woe unto me if I preach not the gospel. I stand on preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ because God called me to preach the gospel. Yeah, he called there's no salvation in nobody else but Jesus. Yeah, you can get all the other stuff that you want. You can get all the worldly stuff that you want, but it's not of Jesus. We got to make sure that we're not being deceived and separate this thing. We got to separate the world from kingdom. We can't mix. It's like oil and water. It can't mix. John 1:1 said this, and this is establishing who Jesus is. This is establishing why we shouldn't be deceived. John said in John 1:1, he said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. See, we got to understand that you can't separate Jesus. If Jesus is God, he came in the flesh. And we got to understand that what we stand on as believers, we cannot be deceived, because Jesus is the living Word. He said the same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life. In Jesus is life. I'm going somewhere with this. I want us to get this. Believers, don't be deceived. I'm going with this. I want you to have a firm, solid foundation that you can't be deceived by evil men seducing you some other kind of way to take you to another false god with a lowercase g. No idols. In him was life. In him was life. Christ is life. And the life was the light of men. Ha. Jesus is life. Jesus is light. Well, how do I obtain that? I got to come to him and accept him as Savior. Recognize that I'm sinful man. Recognize that there's nothing in my flesh that's any good. Believers, we recognize there's nothing in our flesh that God is pleased with. Nothing. God cannot be pleased with flesh. Because flesh is sinful, it's corrupt, and God cannot deal with corrupt. You got to be born again. You got to have a new life. And until you're born again, you're considered dead. You're a dead man walking. Y'all remember that movie, Dead Man Walking? Dead Man Walking. You remember that? You're a dead man walking until Christ comes into you. Till you accept Christ as Savior, as a sinner. And be saved by grace, you're a dead man walking. When we walk around the world and we see people that aren't saved yet, they're dead people walking. You say, Pastor, that's kind of hard, but I didn't say it. God said it. In him was life. And the life was the light of men. And the light shined in darkness. In other words, Christ shined in the dark. It said the light shined in the darkness. In other words, was nothing that could cover the light of Christ, because he is light and he is light. But guess what? The darkness comprehended not. Yeah, the darkness comprehended not. We have a lot of darkness yet in the world. But as the body of believers, if you're not deceived, you are in light when you're in Christ. Believers, I'm trying to help you today. I'm trying to help you today. I'm trying to help you to understand that there's still darkness in the world because of the deadness of mankind that haven't accepted Christ, which is the life, and he is the light. Here it is. And there was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light. We're still bearing witness of the light right now. That all men through him, come on now, all men through him might believe. All men through him might believe. All men through him might believe. But we hear that word all the time, believe. Don't be deceived of believers. Do not be deceived. It's only one way. One way. Here it is. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. Here it is. That was the true light. He's the true light. Jesus Christ is the true light. Which lighteth every man that cometh unto it. Now pay close attention now. Which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. Yeah, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. And the world knew him not. He came into the light. He came into the world that a man would receive the light, that they can have life. But it says right here, but guess what? The world knew him not. The world knew him not. There's a lot of people walking in today that know him not. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. The wolf will come in sheep's clothing. But truly, if they're not believing the Bible and believing the word like Christ said it, then guess what? They're wolves in sheep's clothing. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Here it is. He came into his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave him he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. The way you become a son of God is that you believe upon the name of the Lord Jesus. There ain't no other name other than the name of the Lord Jesus. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. There's only one name under the heavens is Jesus. And if you come in any kind of way, you can't claim salvation no other kind of way. You can claim everything else that you want, but there's only one way. And that's you got to come to that light. He said, but as many as receive him, as many people, as many believers, pay attention, as many people that believed on him, he gave them power to become the sons of God. Everybody ain't the sons of God, y'all. God created everybody, but everybody haven't came to Christ as Savior, y'all. Yeah. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He wasn't created by hand. He wasn't created like we were. He was through the power of the Holy Ghost. He's the only begotten. He's the only begotten. He gave his only begotten son that whosoever believeth of him shouldn't perish. God so loved the world, okay, the world, that he gave his only begotten son, Jesus, that whoever believed. See, he gave, yeah, and then it was something you had to do. You had to believe up that he gave, and then guess what it said? That you won't perish, but have everlasting life. Boy, y'all been quoting that John 3:16 all these years, and you really don't understand what he's saying. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. You got to believe upon Christ and what he did up on Calvary. By grace are ye saved. Yeah, by grace are ye saved. By having faith in what he did up on that cross. Now, if you don't want salvation, then you ain't got to believe that. But believers, I'm trying to keep you from being deceived. If you don't care about where you're going to spend eternity at, then it don't bother you. But I pray that you're a lot of wolves that come into you and try to scatter you around, making you think that you ain't saved, making you think that all you. Now they say to those that are in Christ, there's no more condemnation to those that are in Christ. When you accept Christ by faith through what he did up on Calvary, then you are saved. I don't know your condition right now, but I know that if you accept them on this basis, you are saved. Here it is. Here it is. And I got to go here. Here it is. And it said that even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. So you got to believe that Christ was born. Yeah, you got to believe that he came through the Virgin Mary. You got to believe that he walked this earth in the flesh. You got to believe that he was crucified. You got to believe that he was buried. You got to believe that he ascended into heaven and sit on the right hand of God. Why? Because if you don't believe that, then you don't have the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. According to the scripture. Don't mix no other scripture with this and come tell me that you believe And then you say, well, Christ wasn't the Son of God. He didn't walk this earth. He wasn't in the flesh. Go to John, 1 John 4. Go to 1 John 4. And he said, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we behold his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth, full of grace and truth. Hell, the Word was made flesh. And the only way that you can say that the Word was made flesh is that you are born again believer. And you, the only way that you can say that is that you are born again believer. Don't be deceived. If a man can't tell you that Christ walked this earth in the flesh and he's God, then he will deceive you. Our doctrine is based upon the life, the death, and the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Our doctrine as a believer is solely based upon what Christ did. That's where our roots started. That's where they end at. Anything in between is not of God. You can't build a house until you put a foundation down. I don't care how you do it. You can drill it, concrete in the ground. You can lay block in the ground. You can put wood on the ground. But you got to have a foundation. And the Word was made flesh. Christ is the Word. The living Word. The Word that can transform you into a being a believer. The Word that can change your stony heart into a flesh heart. The gospel Word that Jesus died for your sins. Oh, hallelujah. And your heart will cause you to repent and turn from the world. Your heart will make you repent through God to make you see the cross. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Go to 1 John. John gonna tell you something else. I just want us to believe us to not be deceived. Not be deceived. Don't allow the wolf to come in and scatter you. Because it said that Satan is as a roaring lion seeking to he could destroy. We got to understand that the enemy comes in all shapes and forms. But the enemy's main objective is to take your eye off the cross. The enemy's main objective is to get you not to believe in the deity of Christ Jesus. The enemy's main objective is to make you think that you're yet a sinner, even though you have accepted Christ as your Savior. The enemy's objective is to put your mind on worldly things so you can take your eye off the cross. The enemy's job is to make you think you're still in sin and Jesus didn't come in the flesh. The enemy's job is to deceive you, to make you think that you are still condemned, even though you accepted Christ as your Savior. We got to be careful of the enemy deceiving you. 1 John 4 in the back of your Bibles. Pastor, you're so hard on wanting us not to be deceived. Yeah, because I don't want you led astray. Because the sheep can be led astray. In this time like we're going through right now, with all that's going on in the world, and people are not able to come together like they normally come, that's when the enemy wants to come in. Because he feel like you're in disarray. So I feel like I can come in and feed you any old thing and take you out of your salvation. But they can't take your salvation from you if you're standing on that true gospel of Jesus Christ. Well, Pastor? Well, I know I'm a believer. Well, John goes on to tell the little children, which are the children of God. He tells them in chapter 4 of 1 John. John says it like this. Beloved. And Pastor Cromwell is telling you like this. Beloved. not every spirit. I'm going right back into what Paul was saying about in Timothy about the evil people that can deceive you and seduce you to bring you into some kind of other knowledge or some kind of other way other than Jesus Christ. He said, remember those things that you were taught as a child about the Holy Scriptures that was a salvation only through Jesus Christ. Remember those things. Why? This is why. Because John, oh man, I got to understand that the apostles and all of them kept reminding the children of God, those that were born again, those that accepted Christ as their Savior, began to let him be Lord of their life. He had to continue to tell them, be aware. And it said right there, beloved, believe not every spirit. Everybody that come to you ain't preaching the gospel. Everybody that come to you ain't preaching the gospel. Well, Pastor, what is the gospel? The death, the burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ that you're saved by grace through faith in what he did up on Calvary. Allow him to be Savior. Your sins are forgiven. Without the shedding of blood, there's no remission of sin. He shed blood on Calvary for those that will believe upon him as Savior. Repent. And God will put a repentant heart in you and be born again. Believe not every spirit. John 1, guys. John, 1 John. 1 John. I went from John, the Gospel of John, chapter 1, to 1 John. 1 John in the back of the Bible. And he said, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit, whether they be or of God. He's telling you right then, John said, look, try the spirit. Try the spirit and make sure that these spirits be of God. Well, why he's saying that, Pastor? Well, go on into the scripture and he's going to tell you why. Here it is. Hereby, ye know ye the spirit of God. This is how you want to know the Spirit of God. Pay attention. If a person come to you, believers, be not deceived. If a person come to you, I don't care who he is, pastor, preacher, teacher, whoever he is. But if he come to you, you try the Spirit. How am I going to try the Spirit? Here it is. He said, hereby know ye the Spirit of God. Every spirit that confesseth that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is of God. If somebody tell you that Jesus Christ didn't come in the flesh, he is not of God. I don't care who he is. Because the only way you can believe it is that you have the Spirit of God. Believers, believers, believers. If somebody tell you that Jesus didn't come in the flesh, they are not of God. Flee, run. Get away from them. Because it's going to be damnation upon you, because the Bible said that those who do not believe upon Jesus Christ as the Son of God is already condemned. You already condemned. It's powerful, man. But so many believers are being led astray because won't nobody preach the gospel. So many believers are sitting at home still like they're condemned because they feel like all the stuff they done did in their past life since they've been born again is still hanging over their head. But there's no more condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus. Wake up! You have been made alive. Every spirit that confesses not that Jesus has come in the flesh is not of God. Let me repeat that. And every spirit that confesses not that Jesus Christ is come in the flesh is not of God. I don't care who it may be. If they say Jesus didn't come in the flesh, they are not of God. Don't be deceived, believers. There's only one way. And Christ said, if you come any other way and other through that gate, you're a thief and a robber. I don't care who it is. You're a thief and a robber if you're not coming through God's way, through his son. You're a thief and a robber. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived with the false prophets. Don't be deceived with the false preachers. Don't be deceived with the false whatever. If they're not saying that Jesus came in the flesh, flee. Don't kill the messenger. When they killed Jesus, they thought they were doing something good, but they, I mean, they thought they were doing something bad, but they were doing something good. Hallelujah. I thank God that he went up on that cross for me today. I thank God that he saved those wretched sinners like me today. I thank God for the blood that was shed up on Calvary today. I plead the blood, and I'm able to plead it because I believe in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I believe it. Yeah, I can plead that blood. People need to be careful about their pleading the blood, but they don't believe. Can't plead no blood if you're not saved. You can't plead no blood if you ain't saved. If you ain't accepted Christ as your Savior, admit that you're a sinner, admit that you're fallen, admit that you're depraved, admit that ain't no good in you, and you come to him as Savior, you can't plead no blood. Quit playing with that word, plead blood. You can't plead no blood. No, you can't plead no blood. Here it is, and this is the spirit of Antichrist. Anybody that said that Christ didn't walk this earth as a man, that's the spirit of Antichrist. And all this whole fooling right there, he the Antichrist. Now, if you don't believe that Christ walked this earth in the flesh, you the Antichrist. That means you're anti-Christ. That means you don't believe in Christ. All this whole foolish teaching, that means if you are anti-Christ because you don't believe that he walked the earth as a man in the flesh. That means you're anti-Christ. You're like some people that say you're anti-social. That means you don't talk to people, you don't deal with people. Anti-freeze will make your car not freeze. See what I'm saying? Anti-Christ means you don't believe in Christ. Then guess what? You don't have no salvation. But if that's what you want, then that's fine. But believers don't be deceived. Yeah, believers don't be deceived. We got a lot of people raising up right now. A lot of different religions, a lot of different stuff. But if they're not preaching Christ crucified, flee. Well, Pastor, you so angry. No, I'm not angry. It said, be mad and sin not. Be angry and sin not. I'm angry because of deceivers, false teachers, false doctrine. Lying about my Savior Jesus Christ. Saying that that's some other kind of way. It ain't but one way. And a true preacher ought to be angry about false doctrine. You ought to be. It's something to be upset about. Because there ain't but one way. And if you come any other way, close this book up and don't use this book any other way than what the books say. Jesus Christ lived and walked on this earth. He walked in the flesh. And if he did come like that, then you'll still be lost in your trespasses. And that takes me to Ephesians 4. Ephesians 2. And I'm going to come back here. But let me take you somewhere right quick. I'm going to take you to Ephesians 2. Ephesians 2. Ephesians 2. Why am I so revved up about Jesus Christ? Ephesians 2, Paul teaching about Jesus again. Oh, I got to tell you, all believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. That's one way. Don't be deceived. As the born-again believer, you must understand. You must understand as a born-again believer. As a born-again believer, you must understand. And in chapter 2 of Ephesians to one of the churches in Ephesus, Paul wrote this epistle. And Paul said in chapter 2, the apostle Paul said in chapter 2, it said that in you had he quickened. You, meaning me, as a born again believer, had he quickened. Quickened means made alive. See, I was a dead man until I accepted Christ. You was a dead person until you accepted Christ. Then he quickened. see, you were dead in trespasses and sin. Yeah, if you didn't come to Christ and say that, then you still ain't saved. I don't know why people don't recognize that you're a sinner. Sinner, saved by His grace. Ain't nothing you did to save yourself. You couldn't save yourself. He said, where in time past you walked according to the course of the world. Did he just say that? I know Paul didn't just say nothing about the world. And Jesus said something about the world. But we seem to think the world is so good. Why do people think the world is so good and Jesus? And he did. He said, and you had he quickened who were dead in trespasses and sin. Believers, don't be deceived. Why in times past, believers, ye walked according to the course of the world. And in times past, I walked according to the course of the world. I don't walk in the course of the world no more. But in time past, I walked into the course of this world. In time past, you walked in the course of this world. According to the prince of the power of the air. The devil is the prince of the power of the air. The devil is the prince of the power of the air. Believers, don't be deceived. The devil is the prince of the air. But Christ is the prince of peace. The only way you can have the prince of peace is that you believe upon him for salvation. And then he'll give you a peace that surpasses all understanding. Believers, don't be deceived. And he said, the spirit that now working in the children of disobedience, he was disobedient. But now the spirit that working into the children of disobedience, among who also had a conversation in times past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath. By nature, nothing that you had to learn, nothing that you had to grow up trying to do, but by nature, we were already the children of wrath. By nature, we were already born into sin and shaped in iniquity through what Adam and Eve did in the Garden of Eden. By nature, we were already the children of wrath. In other words, the wrath of God was upon us by nature. You need to hear this, believers. You need to hear this because I don't want you deceived. And it said, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. Here it is. But God. This is what I want you to understand, believers. Don't be deceived. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love, wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sins. He loved us when we were dead in sins. Had quickened us up together with Christ. By grace are ye saved. Don't be deceived, guys. You can't work enough. You can't give enough. There's nothing that you did, but while you were dead in your sins, when you accepted Christ, he quickened you up together with Christ. By grace are ye saved. And he said, and raised you up together, and guess what? Has set us together in heavenly places. Don't be deceived. In Christ Jesus. But the only way that you can be there in Christ Jesus is that you got to believe upon him. Here it is. That the age to come, that he might show the exceeding riches of his grace and his kindness towards us through Christ Jesus. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ unto good works, which God had before ordained that we should walk in them. It's all because of God's grace. It's all because what we believe that Christ did upon Calvary. It's all that we believe that his blood was given for us to redeem us. He reconciles us back to God. And what he did up on Calvary is not by works. It's not of yourself. It's all because of Christ Jesus. It has to start from the foundation. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Your works and your righteousness, they're no good unless you believe it upon Christ solely upon what he did up on Calvary. Well, what must I do, Pastor? What must I do, Pastor? You got to believe upon the Lord Jesus. Go to Romans 10 and 9. Romans 10 and 9 said it like this. Romans 10 and 9 said it like this. Believers, you need to confess it. You need to confess. Romans 10 and 9 said that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thy heart that God had raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. And then it said, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confess unto salvation. See, there's only one way, and Christ is the way. There's only one way, and his blood has washed away. And come on now, it said, for the scripture said, whosoever believeth of him shall not be ashamed. Don't be ashamed of the gospel. Confess the gospel. Confess that you believe that God had raised Jesus up from the dead. Don't be deceived that there's another way. Don't be deceived about what you're seeing around the world. It's one way. He said, for there's no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. For whosoever shall call upon his name, or the name of the Lord, shall be saved. He don't care who you is. He don't care where you're from. He don't care what school you went to. He don't care if you didn't even go to school. But if you will call upon the name of the Lord Jesus, you shall be saved. He don't care how many degrees that you have, you shall be saved. If you, oh hallelujah, if you believe he died for your sins, if you believe the blood has washed away your sins, if you believe he was buried, oh hallelujah, and if you believe that he was raised up on the third day by the power of God, you shall be saved. If you believe that he is the only Savior, you receive the Holy Ghost. You shall be saved. There's no other salvation, no other where, no other place you can gain salvation other through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. One faith, one Lord, and one baptism. Baptism of the Holy Ghost. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. And then he goes on to say that there's no difference. See, because God is no respecter of person. He don't care if you're rich. He don't care if you're poor. He don't care if you're black. He don't care if you're white. He's no respecter of person. And guess what? The devil don't either. The devil will use whoever he wants to deceive you. You got to discern, believers. You got to discern, believers. You got to discern. You got to know the difference if it's the Spirit of God. You got to try the Spirit. Don't be deceived. Don't be led in error saying that you got to do a bunch of this and a bunch of that to be saved. There's only one way to be saved, and that's believing upon the Lord Jesus Christ for salvation. Not by works that no man should boast. Not of you and yourself. We got to believe this. We got to believe this. We got to walk this. John said again in 1 John, and he said, he went on to say this, and he said, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. You overcome the world. Because greater is he, this is John 4 and 4, y'all. Ye are of God, little children, believers, and have overcome them. Hallelujah. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Greater he that is in you than he that is in the world. If you want something to make you feel like you have strengthened the power of the Holy Ghost, then you know greater he that is in you than he that is in the world. Hallelujah. And it says this, they are of the world, therefore speak they of the world. See, the deceiver gonna speak of the world. Don't be deceived, believers. The non-believers gonna speak of the world. He said, they are of the world, therefore speak they of the world. And the world heareth them. See, the world ought to hear somebody that ain't saved, because they hear what Jesus said. Only his sheep can hear his voice. Only his sheep can hear his voice. He said, no other voice will they follow. Only voice we can follow is Jesus Christ. Only voice we can follow is God, because we can't follow nobody else. We can't follow no other voice. Because he said, my sheep know my voice, and another man's voice will they not, they're going to follow it. Yeah. In other words, God know his. Those that have accepted Christ as Savior, we can only follow the Savior. We can't follow the world. Why? He said, they are of the world, therefore speak they of the world. And the world heareth them. The world heareth them. But here it is, we are of God. He that knoweth God heareth us. He that is not of God heareth not us. Hereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. You got to understand the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. You got to know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. And John is going to tell you why. He's going to tell you why. He said, beloved, let us love one another. Let us love one another. Let us love one another. Jesus said, love your neighbor as you love yourself. He said, a new commandment I give you. Yeah. Yeah. And 1 John, write it down in 1 John 3:23, and Jesus said this, and this is his commandment, that we should believe on the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another as he had gave us a commandment. If we're not loving one another, we're not of God. If you're not loving one another, you're not of God. Believers, don't be deceived. If you're not loving one another, it's not of God. And I'm not talking about that smoochy-smoochy love. I'm talking about love unconditionally. Love those who despitefully use you. Pray for those who curse you. Agape love. Meaning that ain't nobody got to do something to you to love them. You love them with the love of Christ. Because God love. God is love. Try the spirit and know if it's in the error in it. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God. Everyone that loves is born of God. You got a new spirit in you. You've been born again, believers. You're able to love now. You weren't able to love when you were dead in your trespass. You weren't able to love then because you were still lost in your sin and trespasses. You didn't have a renewed heart then. You didn't have a right spirit in you then. Born again, believers, don't be deceived. Why do you say that, Pastor? Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. And knoweth God. Here it is. God is love. He that loveth not, knoweth not God. He that loveth not, know not God. If you say you don't love somebody, then you don't know God. Don't be deceived, brothers, sisters. If you got hate in your heart for anybody or anything, you don't know God. Because God is love. Don't be deceived, sisters and brothers. Born again believers, don't be deceived. He that loveth not, knoweth not God. For God is love. was manifest the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son in the world that we might live through him. We were quickened. We were brought up from the dead through Christ Jesus when we believed upon him. That's why your heart has to have love as a born-again believer. And if you had not been a born-again, you can't love. Jesus told Nicodemus that in order for you to see heaven, that you had to be born again. You had to be born of the water and born of the Spirit. You got to have a renewed heart. You got to have a changed mind. You got to have the mind of Christ. Oh, hallelujah. You can't say you hate somebody and love God. Here he is, love. Not that we love God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sin. God seen us on the way to hell, but he gave us a way out. He sent his only begotten Son. So he put his wrath, his full wrath upon his Son. That God loved us. Not that we loved him, but he loved us first. That he loved us so much that he sent his only begotten Son to die for a sinner like you and a sinner like me. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe it upon him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. So we got to understand that God is love. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. We are of God. He that knoweth God, heareth us. He that is not of God, heareth not us. Hereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. If the spirit is not of God with love, then it's of error. It's of the devil. Don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. Believers, believers, I pray today that something was said to strengthen your walk in Christ. Yeah, 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 your walk in Christ. Because it said, beloved, if God so loved us, we ought to also love one another. No man hath seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwelleth in us, and his love is perfected in us. Believers, don't be deceived. Don't be deceived. You've been saved. You were saved by grace through faith in what Christ did upon the cross. Because the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is everlasting life, eternal life. Yeah. And the Bible said that there's no one that seeks God out. There's no one that loves him. There's no one. He said all have sinned and fallen short of his glory. All have sinned and fallen short of his glory. But he gave us a way out when he sent his only begotten Son to die upon that rugged cross. Meant that you're a sinner. Repent. Turn. Turn from the world and walk away from sin. And accept Christ as your Savior. That's the only way to be saved. Any other way is a lie. Christ came to die for sinners. Christ came to die for sinners. He is the way, the truth, and the life. If anybody tell you any other way, they'll lie. And the truth is not in them. They're lying, and the truth is not in them. They're liars. Christ is the only way. Believers, stand on that. Stand on your salvation. Stand on Christ, for it is true. He's the only way. Don't be deceived. Father God, we come right now. We thank you, oh God. We thank you, Father God, for the word that you have given us today. Father God, we thank you for your love and your mercy. Father God, we thank you more so, oh Lord, for your Son, Jesus Christ. The one that you sent, oh God, to die for our sins, that we may have life and have it more abundantly. The one that you sent to go up on Calvary, to shed his precious blood, that we through his blood, through faith in his blood, oh God, could have everlasting life. Those that will believe upon him and him alone could be saved. Father, we thank you for salvation right now, oh God. Father God, we thank you for the trials and tribulations that we go through in this day-to-day walk, Father God. For we recognize that we're just pilgrims, Lord God. We're just pilgrims that's passing through this world right now, oh God. We recognize, oh God, that there's evilness in the world. But Father God, just like you prayed, Lord God, for your disciples, you said protect them from the evil of the world. So right now, oh God, I pray right now that the believers under the sound of my voice, oh God, that you don't take them out of this world, but you protect them from the evilness of this world, that they may go out and share Jesus Christ and share the cross of Christ with others that they may be saved. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity, oh God, to spread your word. Oh Lord God, we pray that the word fell on the heart today that want to be saved. Be saved and saved only because and only through one way. Through your son, Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for the body of believers right now that are here right now in this particular area right now. We bless them, oh God. We ask that you invigorate them. We ask that you stir up in them, oh God, that will to go out and serve your gospel. That will that they will go out and tell the lost world about your son, Jesus Christ. That they will stir up in them, oh God, and witness to those that haven't accepted you right now as Savior. Father God, we thank you for this opportunity, oh God, to bless your believers, oh God, with more powerful words of the gospel. The death, the burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ unto salvation. For the word say that the gospel is the power of God. The gospel is the power of God. The gospel is the power of God. Unto salvation. We thank you right now, oh God. We thank you for the power of the Holy Spirit. We thank you, oh God, for the blood that was shed on Calvary. We thank you, oh God, that you love us so much, that you gave your only begotten. We thank you, oh God. Oh, hallelujah, we thank you, oh God. Father, we just ask right now that you continue, oh God, to guide and lead us in the way that we should go. And all that we do, oh God, to recognize who your son, Jesus Christ, is, and to recognize who we are before you, oh God. This sinner saved by your grace, and that we'll be able to do your blessed will, to do your work, to call others unto Christ. Go out into the down world, go into the highways and the byways, go into the hedges, and tell about a Savior, hallelujah, about a Savior, which is Jesus Christ. Oh, Father, we bless you, we thank you. We give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory. It is in the name of Jesus that we pray, and we say amen, amen, amen and amen. May God keep you. May God guide you. May the Holy Spirit be with you. And the love of Jesus remain with you. From now, henceforth, and forever. God bless you and keep you. Amen.